Next, an intriguing project organized by one school to mark Grandparents' Day. St. Andrew's Secondary School got 200 Set 1 students to interview their grandparents on camera about the past. Now, the clips are being shared with the Singapore Memory Project and the Oral History Center at the National Library Board. Now, all the stories are about living through the Second World War. Here are some of the snippets.
Can you tell us about how people react when Japanese conquer Asia?
You mean all the people very frightened and run for their life when the siren came? You know the siren? They run to the underground, go to the underground. Except me. Because I didn't know anything, you see. Another thing is, you have one family, one ticket to buy a loaf of bread. You know, I'm small and thin. Then everybody push me up, push me back until in the end, I came back in the evening with one bloke, all the dresses all torn.
What's the living conditions like during the Japanese occupation?
Well, during that time, you're either hiding or running away whenever you hear the sound, the siren sounding. It was very dangerous, everybody had to run. Because the Japanese were very cruel. I lost my father, which is your great-grandfather.
I'm so sorry to hear.
Well, that's life.
那你的爸爸为什么会当兵？当初他在黄埔军官学校看到他出榜，出榜要招生，他就去读了。
Now joining me tonight, a student Ho Wei-da and one of the teachers in charge of the project, Denise Fernandez. Welcome to both of you. Wei-da, we saw just now the footage of your grandmother being interviewed there. Did you have any idea about the stories before you spoke to her?
No, I had no idea about her past before I interviewed her. So I was born in China, Hangzhou, and came to Singapore when I was 5 years old. So since then, she had taught me to appreciate the safe and comfortable environment we have in Singapore. And she is always very contented and positive about her life and have never actually mentioned about anything in the past and any sad and hard time stories of the scary war. So it wasn't until I started this project that I learned more about my family history and how interesting it is.
And part of that family history, of course, is that your great-grandfather was a general in the Chinese army. That's pretty cool, that fact. What were the most interesting things that you actually found out?
Most interesting part is actually learning about my great-grandfather, whom I never met before, and learning about his past and getting to know why he actually left the school as a teacher and joined Huangpu Military Training Institution and fought for the war for almost 10 years. Mm.
So Denise, let's bring you in on this conversation. Now, oral history, it's a bit of a lost art. How did you come up with this idea?
I was actually teaching a class on the Japanese occupation. So when you ask for anecdotes from the boys, they actually all these really amazing stories. So we had one boy whose grand aunt is actually a comfort woman. So basically, it was very heartwarming for me to see my students being really active contributors and being really concerned about the past. And I think this was something we wanted to foster, and something that we wanted to engage them with the past with.
So what impressed you most then about how the students actually went about this and how they got it done?
I'm actually very, very happy with the change in the students, because before this, when we first started out the project, I had this student who said to me, ma'am, my grandmother is really blur and she doesn't know anything. And after that, when he actually interviewed his grandmother, he actually said to me, you know what, my grandmother actually knows a lot. And I said to them, I said to Wei-da's class, I said, when you're going to be old like me one day, you're going to wish that you asked the questions that you didn't ask. And it's important that you ask it now and you build that empathy and resilience. And I'm actually happy that, Wei-da's dad is one of the parents who said this to me. Some of the boys are actually voluntarily calling their grandparents and actually asking them, how was your day? How are you? And I really am very happy to see that they have developed this empathy and this resilience.
So as we saw there, in that clip, some of the memories that grandparents talked about, you know, their tough memories, challenging times and so on. I mean, did the students face any specific challenges with communicating with their grandparents or getting them to talk about such painful memories?
Yes, I think one of the main difficulties we had was actually that the students were not really totally fluent enough in their mother tongue to actually sustain a long conversation with their grandparents. And this is why I'm very grateful actually to be in a school like SA in St. Andrews, because we believe in something called One Family Unbroken. So I had colleagues like Valerie from, you know, the EL department who supported me, and my colleague Lim from the mother tongue department, and my other colleague Geraldine in the humanities department, who really, really supported me through this. And it's because of that that I think the students were able to engage their parents effectively and communicate, and they were able to get the important messages across.
All right, thanks very much for coming into the studio and sharing all that with
us.
Thank you very much. Denise Fernandez there, and Weda. Now, moving on,